Hi, I'm Dr. Clive Oliver. I'm a senior lecturer in the Department of Chemistry at the University of Cape Town. What does that mean? Well, it means that I teach chemistry at all levels, from first year fundamental chemistry to specialized advanced topics in our honors program. In addition, I supervise several MSc and PhD students as well as postdoctoral fellows.
What does your research entail?
Well, firstly, I'll classify myself as a solid-state supramolecular chemist. That means that in my research group, we develop novel materials which find their applications in the solid state. One of these materials are called a metal organic framework, or MOF for short. So what is a metal organic framework? Well, it is a coordination polymer. I have a simplified model here of a MOF. It is a coordination poly that consists of metal ions as nodes and organic molecules as linkers. The reason that these MOFs are so popular, more than 100,000 new MOFs have been synthesized in the last 20 years, is that they have large internal voids within their structure. And so they can act as host materials for several molecules for various applications. One such application would be the capture of carbon dioxide. So this is my carbon dioxide molecule with carbon in the middle and two oxygen atoms on the side. The voids of these materials are large enough so that a carbon dioxide molecule can be trapped inside this material. So our challenge is to make different materials with different chemical functionalities to see how we can best trap molecules such as carbon dioxide. This is but one part of the applications of these MOFs. But of course, as chemists, if we have synthesized these molecules, we need to know that we've actually synthesized the correct materials. And so here I'm going to lead you or tell you about my other passion, and that is X-ray diffraction. So we take a crystal of a molecule such as this, we bombard it with X-rays from the side, and then these X-rays will deviate. And we can work then mathematically backwards depending on the deviation of these X-rays and the intensities on what the structure of the material was.
Why do you do this research?
Well, it's exciting. It's exciting to synthesize novel materials which no one else in the world has yet made, and then to discover the key physical and chemical properties which lead to their improved properties. I would say that this work requires an inquiring mind, but also patience. Patience because many new experiments may fail initially, but ultimately they lead us to the path of a positive result. So if you've always wondered about the world around us, the materials and what they are made of, I would say that chemistry is the career for you. You will learn and study and get to know the extreme detail and care that chemists take, and scientists at large for that matter, in determining the molecular structure of materials. Thank you.